Hello, it's Tuesday. Time for our weekly e-blast. Glad you can join with us and take a few minutes to just share what's going on. Sunday was a phenomenal Sunday. We have our campus pastors, Pastor Gary at Spring and Pastor Tim at our Magnolia campus that shared Sunday in the services. Both great sermons. Got to listen to both of them. For those who don't know, if every month of the year that has five Sundays in it at Believers Fellowship, on that fifth Sunday of the month when there's five, the campus pastors have been committed to preach those particular Sundays. Gives me a break, but it also blesses the church to get different insights, different viewpoints, and really have a healthier menu of pastoral teaching. And I thank God for these men that God has given us, two guys that love Jesus, two guys that we have such unity in our fellowship and our leadership. It's just an amazing thing that God has done in blessing our church this way, in fact, blessing me this way. Because there are some things that literally might drive each and every one of us crazy. But praise God, these guys are just an absolute blessing. And I thank God for them regularly, as you should as well, and continue to pray for them. But Sunday services were great. Attendance is slowly, as I said, creeping back up. Those of you getting vaccines are starting to come back. Some of you just now getting your second dose of vaccines, and they're coming back. Some people ask me, well, aren't you afraid? You know, you do two services, you're driving back, you're exposed to all these people. Add to that, you're going all over the place doing funerals and services and memorial services like that as well. No, I'm not afraid of getting COVID-19, period. I'm just not. I know that if you listen to the news long enough and listen to the stories long enough that you can get scared, you know, out of your bejeebers, if that's even a word in the dictionary. But I don't pay attention to those things. I want to take cautions. I wash my hands. I come in from places. I change my clothes. I take care of myself and do the right things. Wear a mask when I need to. So, no, I'm not going to choose to live in fear. I'd rather be with the people I love, be with my family, be with my grandkids, be with my church, be with my church body, than to worry about those things. When there's a 99.9%, you know, recovery rate, I'm not too afraid, all right? And you shouldn't be either, praise the Lord. You trust the Lord with our lives, with our limbs, and everything else about us. So let's just continue to believe God. I got this article last year, all right, called 10, I don't know if it shows up backwards on Facebook or not, 10 church members who drive me crazy. Now, I didn't write this because I might have added three or four more, but it was written by Chuck Lawless, who works at Southwestern Seminary, the Southern Baptist Convention, writes a lot of articles and writes for a lot of Christian organizations and stuff. But he wrote this, and it's kind of humorous. He says, I love the local church. I really do, deeply. But almost every church I know has members and attenders to get under the skin of the pastor or the church leaders. Here are 10 people that do it for him. I mean, this is Chuck Lawless, not Pastor Joe Arms. So they can be humorous. There's the doom and gloom member, all right? Nothing ever goes right for the doom and gloom member, all right? Nothing's either his fault or her fault. This person said, I don't like to see that person coming my way on Sunday. And then there's the on the edge of leaving member. This is that member who's always threatening, you know, to leave over something, so much so that you kind of learn to ignore this person, he says, and kind of wish they would go ahead and leave. Then there's the amateur theologian member. We always have some people like this. They think they know theology, and they're always debating something. Usually they have a little particular pet theological stance that they want to defend and promote. Number four in the countdown, the did you know member. He wants to be in the know about everything in the church. In fact, he's involved in almost all the church's gossip, and he gets angry when he's left out of the loop. Number five. Oh, that's that church member, that did you know church. They always like to come to the pastor and say, everybody's saying. You can usually tell that person's in the loop. All right. Number five, the recommitment member. She shows up, he shows up about every 6 months. They want to recommit their life to Jesus, and then they disappear for six more months. And then there's the constitutional lawyer member. They have the church constitution, bylaws, and folder in their home. They know it by back of their hand. And anytime there's something that this person in the church doesn't like, they like to bring the documents out. The number seven. The internet sermon troll. Now, there's a lot of these folks that we can be careful. I'm sure that in a lot of churches, he said, they listen to everybody else's sermons online. They critique my sermons, he says, in light of the other preachers. And indeed, he listens for errors more than he listens for truth or any application that might involve him. Counting down number eight. The nostalgia freak member. She knows everything about the church history. She sees her role as protecting, and it could be he or her, all right, as protecting the past by fighting against anything that might be different or anything that might be new. You just know she's going to post something before you even bring it up. the number nine, and this is the unforgiving saint member. And this is where we have to be cautious of. This unforgiving saint member gets angry over something that happened years ago. They're still mad about it. They refuse to let it go. When confronted about it, they just spiritualize the reasons that with the best of anybody else that can rationalize. And number 10, you ready? The on sabbatical member. I'm on sabbatical. No matter what you do, this member refuses to serve in the church. And many times they come up with this one. Well, I've done my duty in the past. He summarizes all this. To be honest, folks, like these make pastoral ministry less than fun some days. Here's my encouragement. Take time to pray specifically for any of these members that might be in your fellowship. And maybe God will change a few of them so they don't drive you completely crazy. Well, I appreciate that from Chuck Lawless. I thought you might see that a bit familiar. Sometimes it may just be from my pastor friends who watch our particular weekly commitment here. But whatever it is, we should all be members of a fellowship, and we should also be regular members of the fellowship, and we should all be, are you ready? Serving members of the fellowship. God has something for every one of us to be a part of and something for every one of us to be doing. So I am praying that you have found your place and you're serving God. And you know what happens as a result of that? Instead of finding time to critique things, you find time for joy, time for blessings, ways to help other people and encourage other people. And you find yourself as a result, whatever man sows, that should also reap. You find yourself as a result reaping joy, reaping encouragement, and reaping blessings. Your pastor loves you. Praise God. I don't know. We have too many of these people in our church or at either campus, but they always help us to, a friend of mine called them heavenly sandpaper. Help us keep us refined, serving the Lord, humble and committed. I love you. God bless you. And I'll talk to you next Tuesday. Thank you for listening today.